In the previous video, we downloaded WordPress. We're now going to upload it to our web host using the cPanel. Go to your web browser and type in your website's URL in the address bar, but at the very end, type /cPanel and click Enter. You should now see the cPanel login page that looks like this or very similar. Type in the username and password that was provided by your hosting service and press the login button. Here you will see many different web options, but the one we are interested in at the moment is the file manager. Once you find the file manager, click on it and a box will pop up. When it does, click on Go. This is the online area where all the files from your website are going to be stored. Let's go ahead and upload WordPress. Click on Upload and then browse to where you saved your copy of WordPress and press Open. You are now uploading WordPress to the internet, and you can see the status of the upload down here. Once your upload has finished, click on the Go Back link. As you can see, you have now uploaded WordPress, but it's compressed in the zip file. Let's go ahead and extract the files from the zip. Click on the WordPress file you uploaded and click on Extract. Then click on Extract Files. This box shows you all the files that you extracted from the zip. Click on Close. You might not see anything at the moment, but that's because we haven't refreshed the page. First, let's delete the WordPress zip as it takes up space and is no longer required. Make sure it is highlighted and click on Delete. Then Delete Files. Now let's refresh the page by clicking on Reload. As you can see, a folder has been created, and that's where all the files from your WordPress website are stored. Now double click on the folder, and here you can see all the files that belong to WordPress. Now, there is one last thing we need to do. If you visit your website now, you will notice that there is a link named WordPress, and once you click on it, it will load the WordPress installation. This means that currently, your website will not load straight away once a user visits your website, but it will load once they click on the link. This is because when we extracted the WordPress zip file, all of the files were extracted into a folder called WordPress. To fix this, we need to move all of the WordPress files into the main directory, which is public_HTML. We first need to select all of the files. We can do this by clicking on Select All. Once all of the files have been highlighted blue, click on the Move File button at the top. In the Path field, delete everything after public_HTML. Once your path looks like this, click on the Move Files button. The directory should now be empty, and because all of your files have been moved into the main directory, which means if you visit your website now, your WordPress installation will load straight away, which also means that once a user visits your URL, your website will load straight away. Since we do not need the WordPress folder anymore, let's go ahead and delete it. Click on the Back button to go to your main directory. Here you will see all of your WordPress files. Click on your WordPress folder and then click on the Delete button. Congratulations! You have now just uploaded your first WordPress website.